welcome to another edition of Your Bridge to Addiction Resources, a program that is sponsored by the Council on Chemical Abuse and the People's Chronicles. My name is Yvonne Stroman, and with me today, I have a very special friend whom I asked to come and join us to talk a little bit about, number one, what he does in our community, which is a lot. So if you have a cup of coffee and kind of rest yourself, he's going to share with you a number of things that he does, but also talk about an upcoming program on October 15th that I think that you'll be interested in hearing more about. So I'm going to ask him to introduce himself and give us a little bit about what he does in the community.
Hello, I'm Giovanni Bedoya. I'm a campaign manager for the United Way of Berks County and a very proud board member for the Council on Chemical Abuse.
Thank you, Giovanni, for coming to speak with me for a little bit. And so you talked about being a board member for the Council on Chemical Abuse. Now, I also know that you were employed at one point in time by the Council on Chemical Abuse. And what did you do when you were an employee?
So about 3 years ago now, I was hired as a consultant to do some tobacco cessation, meaning I was helping others kick the habit of smoking. But not only doing that, I had to do that in Spanish. Mm. So when I came on board, there was tons of opportunities to diversify what COCA was doing. And that's kind of how I got involved with the gambling part of it as well. So a different department needed some help as well as to do bilingual servicing. So I assisted with gambling addiction awareness, and then it grew into helping with the Healthy Corner Store Initiative here in Berks County, where the local bodegas have Latino owners, and I would come out and talk to them and educate on making better choices on food items that they would sell. So the idea was to promote healthier eating, selling fresh produce. Just when you walk into a grocery store, the first thing you see is all the sugar,
right?
All the candy, all the displays. So the big thing was, let's try to change that. And through this program, which is funded by the Department of Health, they want you to promote produce. So they give you baskets, and of course you have to meet a certain criteria, but we give them some perks for participating. So so a couple of things over there.
how was that received by the bodegas? Understanding that, you know, candy sells.
Of course.
Soda sells.
Exactly.
So changing that frame of thought, the attitude about that, was it tough?
It's tough. It was tough. It is tough, continues to be that way. Just in general, our community, Latino community is, you know, sometimes they have trouble trusting these types of programs.
Okay.
Because we're just not used to that type of assistance. A lot of our Latino bodegueros, which is what we call them, the bodega owners, they start the business from scratch on their own. You know, everything's by themselves. They are not very aware or business savvy as well. So a lot of these things are foreign to them. And even, you know, with the tobacco cessation, same thing. This type of assistance isn't available very much out there. So to them, it's something new. They're not sure if they can trust it. So they, you know, it's just a matter of education, and that's kind of what I stepped in for and came in to do.
Do you think it's kind of like maybe they feel as though someone is coming in, stepping in on their territory and trying to tell them how to sell things, you know, and what products that they should be putting out in their store and that kind of thing?
That's exactly it.
Yeah.
And it's not only just a trust issue because it's an outside organization. It's a trust issue on, well, I've been doing this for 20 years and it's working, so why do I need to change it? Why am I going to spend money on a piece of produce that can expire in a few days versus a canned good or a sugared item that can last for years?
And so, but I suspect that along the way, you and your charisma, you have a way of really talking with people and engaging them so that they can perhaps think about some of the information that you're sharing with them, and not only that, maybe even change some behaviors and attitudes around that. So,
You know, it just come. You know, growing up in the streets of Jersey, North Jersey, you know, I'm one of them. We struggled. My parents were struggling here as immigrants. You know, they came to this country. Same history that a lot of these bodegueros have. It's just a lack of education, a lack of knowledge. So coming in there and, you know, just being real with them, telling them the reality of the damage that we're causing to ourselves as a community diabetes, high blood pressure, all these things are such an issue in our minority community that we need to make some changes. And this is a perfect example of how we can make those changes.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
I'm excited to be to say that I was part of that movement.
That's so wonderful.
Yeah.
And so you had an opportunity come along your way,
yeah,
and now you are working at the United Way.
Correct.
And you talked about being part of the campaign.
Yeah.
Can you talk a little bit more about what
sure
that means?
So as a campaign manager, my job is to assist workplace campaigns. So
okay,
if you work somewhere and you participate during our United Way campaign, I help the coordinators raise the money.
Okay.
So it could be anything from just giving them some techniques on how to raise money,
mm-hmm,
or how to reach out to their workers. It could be me doing presentations on why they should give and why they should donate. So lots of working together with other coordinators like mm-hmm yourself.
Yes, no problem. Not a problem. Anything to help raise the community
yeah
to be in a better place than
of
where
course
it once was.
This is a very giving community, mm-hmm, and just when I started working there, it was one of the biggest reasons I went, because they're all about helping the community. I mean, we're raising $10 million this year.
Yeah.
For Berks County.
That's great. Yeah, it stays right here.
Yeah,
that's important to know that it stays
Berks
right here.
For Berks.
Yeah.
That's the
yeah
thing I say to everyone. It's money raised here for here.
Yeah.
Which is incredible.
That's super.
So, yeah.
Yeah. And so how do you think has your thought process or ideas about helping Berks County shifted, going from an employee at the Council on Chemical Abuse to now you're like, you know, a board
yeah
member and you're
yeah
responsible for some heavy duty decision making?
Yeah.
And,
yeah,
and how do you do that?
It's a huge honor to be part of that. The minute I got noticed that I was being considered to join the board after I had moved on, I was just super excited.
Yeah.
I was serving on many other boards in Lancaster County, where
mm-hmm
I'm from,
mm-hmm,
and decided to withdraw myself from those so I can come and dedicate some more time here in Berks and with COCA specifically. So it was very exciting. You know, there are lots of decisions that have to be made behind the scenes. There's millions of dollars that come in through
mm-hmm
the organization, being that we're the single county authority.
Yes.
Meaning federal, state, local money comes
mm-hmm
through us to disperse to other organizations that help people with addiction issues and prevention, treatment, that type of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So it's very exciting. I mean, I love it. I love doing that, doing those things for the community, and knowing that I'm a part of that change and a part of that education and prevention and all that. So it's very exciting.
Well, certainly, I want to say before we end here that I certainly thank you for your leadership. And you've been at the forefront, you know, in terms of the local grassroots level
mm-hmm
and working with the local bodegas. And now you have that insight that you can bring around
exactly
the table
yeah
and say, you know what, let's wait a minute here. Are we doing the right thing in the best interest of the community as a whole? And I also applaud you because one of the initiatives that's being taken place relatively soon is Esperanza para Berks.
Yes.
And you were approached about doing something in the Latino community that is totally in Spanish, which has never been done before.
Correct.
And can you talk a little bit about
sure
what this event is?
So Esperanza para Berks is just an idea that came about because we noticed that many people do conferences, workshops, just kind of any kind of educational pieces to the community about addiction
mm-hmm
in English.
Yeah.
And even if it's labeled as a Spanish event or a bilingual event, it becomes that bilingual event.
Mm-hmm.
We want to make sure we reach that grassroots community, those people that are in the streets struggling with addiction issues in their families. So Esperanza came up. Well, let's help those families. Let's show them that we have those resources
yeah
at COCA. They're available.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas, you know, this area is a huge population of Latinos.
Yes, it is.
Non-English speaking population.
Mm-hmm.
Yet we have the most need in addiction treatment. If someone needs to go to a detox or needs to get some help, people get turned away because they don't speak English, because
mm-hmm
the facility doesn't have a bilingual counselor
yeah
or treatment provider. So those are the issues that we have to deal with. So what happens if you turn someone away who's addicted to drugs? They're going to go back to doing the drugs, overdose, and commit crimes, and do all the things that we get put into this stereotype
mm-hmm
and into the statistics. So we're addressing this dead on. head on, I mean, I'm sorry, and no one's had the guts to do something like this. I'm proud to say that in this entire region, because like I said, I'm also from Lancaster County, and there are other rehabs out there. No one's done it over there. No one's done it in Lehigh and all of our surrounding counties. So we're doing something in Spanish completely for our community for free. And of course, we have some door prizes. We have a keynote speaker, and this is all an entire panel of professionals. So what we did was I gathered every single Latino professional or bilingual professional in the business in this county, and they're all part of this committee.
That's so wonderful.
There's tons of other people that are dedicated to this movement. So yeah. We're creating Esperanza para Berks, where we're just going to educate families
That's
on
wonderful.
Addiction and how to handle it. People may have questions because we have lots of stigmas as a culture that we don't want to deal with. We don't want others to know our business. We're proud. We just hide a lot of stuff, and we're uneducated when it comes to addiction as a disease.
Yeah.
So we're going to tackle all of this.
That's
in
great.
One shot, one day.
Yeah, and you know. The great thing is that what I heard you say is we're gonna tackle this and we're not going anywhere.
Correct.
We're gonna continue to be in the community, continue to be available to the community so that we all can work together and really try to find solutions for individuals yes. that want to get well, whether it's in English or in Spanish.
That's exactly it.
And there's a need there, and you mentioned that, and so it's gonna be next Saturday, October 15th, right?
Yep, the 15th.
And it'll be where will it be taking place?
So we'll be doing it at Centro Hispano, right
okay.
here at 501 Washington Street in Reading, inside their Casa de la Amistad. That's their senior center.
Okay.
So we can fit about 170 people seated, and we're providing lunch. It's a totally free event. We have parking provided as well at the Abe Lincoln across the street. So
wonderful.
We're making it super easy for families to come out and learn about how to treat this epidemic we're having, and not only just Latinos, the entire country, everyone.
Absolutely.
And
yeah.
we do take it into consideration that people may be bilingual.
Mm-hmm.
So even though the event will be in all Spanish speaking during the programming, we are going to have resources and a resource room in both languages.
That's great.
And every provider that's in this area is going to be part of it.
Wonderful. So it's a time for Berks County to make a difference.
Exactly.
You know, make a difference in the Latino community. Let's all, you know, join hands and reach out to one another and say, how can we both help yeah. that person that it's
exactly.
in the best
yeah.
need? So we're wrapping up here, and Giovanni, and thank you again for coming to talk with me. Is there anything else perhaps that we need to just kind of mention before we sign off? That
I always invite anyone that's listening, anytime I ever have an audience. Mm-hmm. It's just take action. Be part of that. Be part of the change. Don't complain. Don't sit back and watch. Let's take action. You know, here's someone in front of you who was from the streets, mm-hmm. grew up in every struggle that you can think of.
Mm-hmm.
I'm taking action because I'm given an opportunity like this to speak to others. So
yeah.
take action.
I appreciate that because actually your request to take action really inspires even me to want to take action. So I just thank you. I thank you again. And so thank you for listening. If you would like more information about Esperanza para Berks, please visit our website at www.cocaberks.org. That's CocaBerks.org. Or give us a call, 610-376-8669. This is your Bridge to Addiction Resources. My name is Yvonne Stroman. Thank you for joining us.
Check back every week for a new story with your Bridge to Addiction Resources. You can call 610-376-8669 or visit online at CocaBerks.org, CocaBerks.org. Be sure to like and follow the Council on Chemical Abuse on Facebook and Twitter.